Hello, and welcome to this presentation, in which I'll talk about open source instrumentation with the Digilent OpenScope MZ. First of all, who am I? My name is Ioan Catuna. I'm an engineer doing hardware and software design at Digilent, Romania. I previously worked at National Instrument Romania, and I have a master's degree in integrated circuits and systems. I'm really passionate about embedded development, FPGAs, and design for instrumentation. You can contact me at this email address. Now, a few words about our company. Digilent Inc. is the world leader in academic and research technology solutions. We manufacture embedded development tools, test and measurement devices, for rapid prototyping and for training purposes. Our revenue in 2014 was $13 million, and our main locations are in the state of Washington in US, in Pullman and Seattle. We also have offices in Shanghai in China, the sales and application engineering, and we also have an R&D center and a sales office in Cluj in Romania. Back in 2012, Digilent was bought by National Instruments, and since then it has expanded. This is a view of most of the product lines that Digilent has. In the center part of the picture, you see the FPGA and the Zynq system on chip boards. To the left, you can see the instrumentation boards. To the right, the microcontroller boards. And to the lower part of the picture, there are the PMODs, the peripheral module line. Now, we believe in open source. For most of our products, we publish the schematics and we share our code. We share it on GitHub. Some of the product lines that Digilent has that are open source are the PIC32 microcontroller line. You may have heard about them in their previous name called ChipKit, the PMOD, peripheral module line, and the open source instrumentation. Now, first of all, what is instrumentation? Like, a ruler is a measuring instrument, a scale is a measuring instrument, a voltmeter and oscilloscope are also measuring instrument. What we call an instrument is a tool that we use to interact with a project, with the product that we have in order to make it work, in order to complete it. And at our company at Digilent, since we're interested in electronics instrumentation, we are focused on measuring certain parameters in electronic circuits. There are many tools in electronics engineering. For example, there are prototyping tools like soldering irons, breadboards, and so on. There are sources like power supplies, waveform generators. There are meters, like analog digital voltmeters and so on. And we also have scopes. There are also scopes like oscilloscopes and logic analyzers and so on. Our open source instrument is the OpenScope MZ. You can see it here. And it started with a successful Kickstarter campaign. We had more than 1,000 backers, and we had tremendous support throughout. You may have heard about this campaign. The OpenScope MZ is a completely open source project. Its case design, its schematic design, its software and firmware are all freely available. At the heart of the OpenScope MZ, there is a PIC32 MZ microcontroller, hence the MZ ending in the name. The most important features that the OpenScope has are the oscilloscope, a two-channel oscilloscope with 12-bit resolution and 2 megahertz bandwidth, a function generator with 10 megasamples per second, logic analyzer, 10-bit logic analyzer, two programmable power supplies, and an upcoming feature is a data logger. What the OpenScope also has for connectivity is an onboard Wi-Fi module. You can see it here. And a USB connection. Its user interface is web-based. You can access it from a browser or from an app on your mobile phone. We have iOS and Android apps. And this picture shows an interesting use case for the OpenScope MZ. You can see that it's connected via USB to a power bank, and that's just for powering it up. And you control it and you see the waveforms that you acquire via an app on your mobile phone. So basically, there is no wire connection between the phone and the OpenScope, such that you can either go to another room to do the measurements, or you can install the OpenScope on a moving platform, like on a robot. And our current pre-order price is $89. This is the user interface. It's freely accessible at waveformslive.com. And we just added the board plot feature to it. Now, this is still in beta phase. So any feedback that you have on this user interface is welcome, and it will shape the release of this interface. And if you don't have yet an OpenScope MZ, you don't need to worry. You can still test this interface without an actual hardware. You can use what we call the Simulate OpenScope MZ mode. So you can enter this webpage, add a simulated OpenScope MZ, and test the interface without any problem. And what I like to highlight is that OpenScope MZ is open source. From a hardware point of view, the schematic and the mechanical files, for example, if you want to print a case for it, these are freely available. The firmware on the PIC32 MZ is also freely available. You can compile it with Arduino IDE or MPLABX. The Waveforms Live user interface, again, freely available. We also have the native iOS and Android app. And we also have what we call the Digilent agent. Now, Digilent agent is a desktop software. You can download it from the Digilent website, install it on your computer. It's necessary for initial setup to update the firmware on the OpenScope, to calibrate it, to set up the connection to the wireless network that you want. And then, if you want to use Wi-Fi to connect to the OpenScope MZ, you don't need the Digilent agent anymore. If you want to continue using the OpenScope with USB connection, then you will continue to use the Digilent agent. If you want to find out more information, you can access it at any time, digilent.com/openscope, and from that point, select the Resource Center button. And all the information that you need is there. There are links also to the software source code, which is published on GitHub. Now, a few words about licensing. The hardware is released under Creative Commons, the schematic and the mechanical files. The firmware is either BSD2 or MIT. In the source files, where you see the BSD2 license specifically stated, that's the license for those files. All the others have the MIT license. It's a similar thing with Waveforms Live. There, some of the files are Apache 2.0 license. All the others are MIT. Digilent Agent is licensed under GPL3. And also, it is important to know that you can always contribute to this project. We welcome any feedback on the existing product, hardware, and software. We have a special section in our forum, in a Digilent forum. We have a section for Waveforms Live and OpenScope MZ. You can post there any problems, any feedback you have. And also, at the same location, we would like to receive any requests for future features for this product, either hardware or software. What do you like to see? What do you like to have in this product? Also, you can add your own features if you like. You can add any hardware features or software features. For example, you can add a new measurement type or an analysis type in Waveforms Live. You can you can define a new instrument in the OpenScope MZ firmware, for example. And also, you don't necessarily need to have an internet connection to access Waveforms Live. You can also access an offline version of it. So, for example, if you install the Digilent agent, you would get the offline version of Waveforms Live. Alternatively, you can also connect an SD card to the back of the OpenScope MZ, and you can put there an offline version of the OpenScope of the Waveforms Live. So you don't necessarily need an internet connection to access the user interface. And we would like to hear from you. If you have any feedback, if you did any update, any change, please let us know. Publish them and let us know.